So now we have something really fun to work with. I've created this sand temple with modeling, texturing, lighting, everything you need to just focus on the destruction components. And what I'd like us to do is I'd like us to tear down these buildings in interesting ways. I want us to take the ground and have an interesting cataclysm, earthquake effect happening. And eventually we're also going to sort of take this idea of being on an external planet or some sort of sci-fi environment, and we're going to have magic spells and things crumble things off and tear things apart, and it's going to be crazy, okay? So the idea is to have fun with destruction in this scene. And for the rest of this course, I'm going to focus primarily on the ground area. We want to create some sort of earthquake-like cataclysm effect that's influenced by magic. Okay, so first things first. I want to have leading dust and smoke follow the shape of tectonic plates. So imagine that on the ground here, we have these big old shapes that are pre-fractured and ready to go. And the first thing that happens is that starting from the foreground and going backwards, or going back towards the temple, we're going to have interesting things of particles, dust, following these shapes and leading towards the temple. After that, what's going to happen is that the big tectonic plates shoot upwards. So we have the plates rotating, kind of creating this jagged environment where, let's say we have plates up here, and, you know, we have stuff like that, and then maybe down here we have some other plates that are kind of rising behind it in a different rotation. Basically, we're breaking apart the ground with these big tectonic plates. Along with that, we're going to focus on the edges of these plates and have them crumble as they rise upwards. So we'll take a look at the edges and imagine some rock, some dust, some pebbles, whatever, falling down only on the edges of these big tectonic plates. In addition, I want to have areas in between these plates which feature small explosions and project debris into the air. And the idea is that, let's say that we have an in-between area right here, where I'm kind of scribbling right now. As the tectonic plate goes upwards, I want debris going up like that in a explosive manner. And not everywhere along this crack, but just sort of random areas, you see these small little mini explosions shoot rock, debris, and dust up in the air. So that way we have motion happening upwards, and we also have motion happening downwards through the crumbling edges. And that's just going to make everything feel more intense. We want that contrast in motion, and having these in-between areas is going to really push that whole idea. So this will last us for the rest of the course, and I wanted to just give you an idea of what we're doing before we do it, so that you know why I'm making certain decisions along the way. So before you go in to Houdini, you start playing with nodes and you start going crazy on the ground plane, take a second, step back from the computer, and think about what you're trying to do for a second. It's really important that you do that, because it's also very easy in Houdini to start off on a little bunny trail of some kind and spend way too much time doing stuff without ever having a big picture idea of what it is you're trying to do. It's really, really important that you take the time to think about this. And it also helps you figure out stuff in Houdini better as well. So here's what I mean. Let's say in my mind, I'm thinking, okay, I gotta get that ground. We have to break that up into some tectonic plates, right? So let's say that we're looking from a vertical vantage point, and these are the plates that we want to make. Well, it's very, very useful to think about this in terms of primary shapes. So that's the big shapes that we see right here. Secondary shapes, that's the smaller shapes within that big shape. Tertiary, even smaller, and detail for things like particles or dust or anything that may be a pixel or less in size. Any really great simulation is going to have these elements. It's going to have these levels of scale present in the simulation. And it's actually a really awesome thing just to always keep in mind whenever you're doing RBD simulations. Now, this is really useful because it helps us plan how we're going to do this. So, if we have a to-do list, we can have that in our head or on paper of how we approach this stuff. It kind of gives us a formula or a checklist of what we need to do in Houdini. So, for example, we need primary shapes. So, I could use, let's say, a texture map, the trace node, and a Boolean to get these shapes. And as you might guess, this is exactly what we'll do. So we'll have that for the primary. For the secondary, we're going to Boolean along those edges. That's where these plates are going to crumble along the edges. So we'll figure that out. For the tertiary shapes, we're going to use that Boolean that happened in the secondary, but we're also going to use another layer of convex decomposition or potentially the RBD material fracture node on those Boolean pieces. We're going to do something like that to get the smaller pieces. And then for the particles, we're going to just emit particles based on the movement of everything that's going on. So just by taking a second to think about this, now when we jump into Houdini, you know where I'm starting. You know what's going through my head. We know that we need to start with the primary. That means getting a texture map to represent these big plates, using the trace node, and then we're going to Boolean that out. We'll get started in the next video.